Dear friends, welcome to this edition of VBS Neuromed, a series of presentations under the heading Corona Radiata e-learning lectures in neuroanatomy. Now, I also call these as lockdown lectures or study at home lectures. Well, we are going through this corona pandemic, and as of now we are at least covering the theory part through online lectures. We hope that sooner or later we will be back in the classroom and the practicals can start. Treat this as the pre-practical preview lectures. The topic very specifically in this series is the spinal cord, part 6, and what we are going to cover is the posterior column or the medial lemniscal pathway, or you can also say details about fasciculus gracilis and fasciculus uniatus. I am Dr. Balasubramanyam. I am working as professor in the Department of Anatomy at St. John's Medical College, Bangalore, India. This slide is a starter slide. It shows a cross section of the spinal cord, the division into an internal gray matter and around that a white matter. The three funiculi, namely anterior, posterior, and lateral funiculi, are highlighted. Today we will go into the details of the posterior funiculus. Related information before starting the discussion: the posterior rootlets, the posterior root and subsequently through the rootlets bring in sensory information which is given from the dorsal nerve ganglion cells. These are the pseudo unipolar cells. From there, these fibers are coming into the spinal cord. Now, this is the representation, pseudo unipolar cells. In this discussion, these are taken as the first order neurons. The peripheral process go to various parts of the body and end in nerve endings. From there, the input is brought, and these pseudo unipolar cells through the central processes send in the information into the posterior column. Now, the fibers do not relay in the gray cortex of the spinal cord. At least the majority, most of the fibers go unrelayed, that means without any synapse, ascend up as long ascending tracts. These are in two components, a fasciculus gracilis and a fasciculus cuneatus. I repeat, these are long ascending tracts. As far as functions are concerned, both the fasciculus gracilis and cuneatus, well, same fibers, same type of functional fibers. They are associated with bringing information, sensory inputs relating to fine touch, two-point discrimination, that means a discriminative touch, proprioception, that means the body identifies its sense of position, where it is, what joint is moved at, to what level, etc. Movements, vibration, pressure, deep pressure. These are the inputs available in this column. The fasciculus cuneatus and the fasciculus gracilis end, as they ascend up, they end in the medullary nuclei. We'll go into the details in due course. They end correspondingly, like the fasciculus gracilis ends in the nucleus gracilis. This is roughly in the mid medulla. Similarly, the fasciculus cuneatus ends in the nucleus cuneatus. Now, the fasciculus gracilis is usually present in the lower part of the spinal column. That means mid thoracic and below, that means T7 and below is fasciculus gracilis. In principle, the more superficial fibers are the ones which are coming in at higher and higher spinal segments. Therefore, the entire fasciculus cuneatus, that is the lateral fasciculus in the posterior column, is made up of C1 to T6 segments. Now, the nucleus gracilis and the nucleus cuneatus are the second order neurons in this three neuron sensory pathway that goes to the cerebral cortex. It's a kind of a relay. That means these fibers of gracilis, fasciculus gracilis and fasciculus cuneatus end respectively in the nuclei in the midmedulla, as just described above. Just a representation to say how the relay takes place. You can see one person handing over the baton to the other person waiting there. Now, besides the nucleus gracilis and the nucleus cuneatus, it is appropriate to mention that in the brainstem, the cranial components the same type of fibers join, and that forms a spinal nucleus and the spinal tract. It is located lateral to the lateral to the nucleus cuneatus. Otherwise, function wise same. This tract, spinal tract, conveys corresponding information from through the cranial, which are brought in through the cranial nerves. Next, at the midmedulla, the fibers, the second order neurons, their axons are efferent to the higher levels. They go through the brainstem. But before that, in the midmedulla itself, the fibers of one side cross to the opposite side. Now, this is known as the great sensory decussation. I repeat, the fibers are the axons that are efferent from the nucleus gracilis and the nucleus cuneatus. These crossover, they go in front of the central canal, and then they cross over to the opposite side and to form two long tracts, that is a medial lemniscus. Now, the flashing dotted circle are the fibers which I just told you crossing to each other. These fibers are known as internal arcuate fibers, and the midline decussation that occurs in front of the central canal is the great sensory decussation. I repeat, great sensory decussation. Next, these fibers ascend up, and there they go through the brainstem, rest of the brainstem. In the pons, they are located in this location, the medial lemniscus, immediately behind the basilar pons. In the midbrain, the medial lemniscus is located in this position. It's a little more posterior because in the anterior part of the midbrain, the crus cerebri, the other components like the substantia nigra, the red nucleus, all these need space. So the medial lemniscus has been pushed a little posteriorly. Next, from here, the fibers continue and end in the thalamic nuclei, ventral postrolateral nucleus of the thalamus. These are the third order neurons. These are the third order neurons. Technically, the medial lemniscus ends here, and the third order neurons give their axons, which go to the cerebral cortex through the internal capsule and the corona radiata. Now, that we will see now. These are the fibers ending in the thalamus. You can see the dotted circles. Next, from here, as I told you, from the thalamus, the fibers go through the internal capsule and the corona radiata to the sensory cortex, of the cerebrum, which we generally call it as sensory homunculus. You can see the proportion in which the various body parts are represented in the cerebral cortex with respect to the sensory modalities. Now, that is basically the same thing we are seeing through an MRI, brain's coronal section. That's the internal capsule, thalamus, and that's the corona radiata. Now, in this way, this tract starts from the dorsal root ganglia and ends in the cerebral cortex. Thank you for your patient hearing. I'm sure you'll have some feedback. Please feel free to write me at this email ID, or you can also pen your feedback in the blog area located below the video in the YouTube channel. Thank you and best wishes.